director of the Center for the Study of International Crises and Conflicts. And then later in the afternoon, we will have a third.
And of course, the Turkish point of view, the Turkish perspective. We will have today the opportunity to listen to our Turkish friends, and I would like also to address my special thanks for their presence, and especially to my good friend Professor Saban Kardas. The recent EU-Turkey action plan for refugees and migration management, and of course the ongoing visa liberalization dialogue. Then we need to take in consideration the position of the major European actors vis-à-vis the Syrian question and recent evolution. Evolutions such as yesterday's decisions in Vienna, where a timeline to when the civil war in Syria was adopted with several steps. The future participation of the Turkish president in some European summits, and the political reinforcement of cooperation and dialogue between Europe and Turkey.
One step back to understand the context in which we are contemplating on possible Turkey-EU cooperation. Rather than trying to address specific issues, I will try to share with you my own observations about what the challenge is currently in the region, because in the next sessions we will talk about specific issues such as the refugees or counter-terrorism issues, where potential Turkish-European collaboration might be taking place. As ORSAM, we are coordinating different research projects in the Middle East. Our teams are visiting different countries. So we are trying to understand what are the main trends, what are the dynamics that are currently shaping the region. Relevant academic literature, this is a very important discussion. But unfortunately in the Middle East, both political underdevelopment and economic underdevelopment, they are feeding each other in a very negative way. And as a result, day by day, when you look at the development indicators for the Middle East, MENA region, the Middle Eastern societies are going backward, politically and economically and socially.
One element of this, Rikso, that we need to work on and keep the pace that this is bringing concrete results. That's still anchoring the whole process in the accession process. The enlargement process, since Turkey is a candidate country, one which has open negotiations 10 years ago. The EU has been the key partner of the region in terms of funding of the refugee crisis since the start. However, much more funds were spent in Lebanon and Jordan, which were in even greater need for these key chapters, and betting also on another development, which is that maybe, well, certainly for the first time in 10 years, we have